Hello dear students, welcome back in our biology series.
So after the digestion, what happened? After digestion or during the digestion, we can say that what? The carbohydrate, that is what? Partially digested food, okay? Carbohydrate nothing but what? Partially digested food gets converts into the simple sugar, that is nothing but what? Glucose, okay? And while digestion process, the fats get converts into the fatty acid and the proteins get converted into the amino acids. Okay, so in this way these are the changes happens, or in this way the food get digested. Whatever the carbohydrate is there, while digestion it get converts into the simple sugar, that is nothing but what? Glucose. Fats get converted into the fatty acid, or we can say that glycerol. Next one is what? The proteins get converted into the amino acids. So all these digestion process is get completed into the small intestine. Okay. So up till now we have discussed the two process of the digestion. First we have discussed about the ingestion. Then we have discussed about the digestion. Okay. So now the food is get digested. But how it will get transported to the different parts of the body or to the different organs of the body? So we will discuss the next process which happens in the digestion process, that is nothing but what? Absorption. Okay, absorption is the third step in the process of digestion. So let's see how exactly the absorption happens in the small intestine. Why it happens only in the small intestine? Because as we know, the digestion process is get completed into the small intestine, and that is the reason the digested food it get absorbed only in the small intestine. Okay, so let's see how it get exactly absorbed. So on the surface of the small intestine, there are the so many small finger like projections are there, okay, and that finger like projections are called as what? Villi. Okay, so millions of finger like projections or the folds called villi on the surface of the small intestine. In the inner side of the small intestine, there are the millions of finger like projections or the fold, and that finger like projections are called as what? Villi, or singularly we can call as what? Villus. Okay, and this each villus has network of thin and small blood vessels called as what? Capillary. Okay, so this each villus is get, you can see that it is the somehow like this structure is there. These are the finger like structures are there, and this all the wall of this villus is get covered with the small or the fine or thin small blood vessels which are called as what? Capillaries. Okay, so we can say in short what? This villus is get covered totally with the capillaries. Okay, so with the help of the capillaries, what happens or why there are the villus which are present in the small intestine? Because it increases the surface area of for absorption. Okay, so this villus helps. Villus is a singular, we can say that villus. Okay, so the villus helps the digested food to absorb the maximum amount of the digested food. It means what? We can say that the villi helps to increase the surface area of the small intestine, which helps to absorb the maximum or the more amount of the digested food. Okay, so that is the main function of the villi. Why the villis are present in the small intestine? Because it helps to increase the surface area for the digestion or for the absorption of the digested food. Okay, so the villi absorbs the digested food, and with the help of these capillaries, the digested food get mixed into the blood. Okay, so villis absorb these digested food, and with the help of the capillaries it get mixed or it get provided into the blood, and with the help of the blood the digested food get transported to the different or to the all the body parts or all the body organs. Okay, so in this way, so now the food get digested, the food get absorbs also. Okay, now the next process is happens. Okay, how that food is get utilized by the body. Okay, so for that we will see the next point, that is what? Assimilation of blood, okay? Assimilation of the blood, and this is the fourth step in the digestion. That is what? Assimilation. The absorption is the third step, okay? First step is what? Ingestion. Second one is digestion. Third one is absorption. Fourth one, now we will discuss, that is nothing but what? Assimilation of food, okay? So let's see how it get utilized, how the digested food is get utilized by the body, okay? So blood carries digested food from small intestine, okay? So the blood carries, how the digested food get mixed into the blood? With the help of the capillary. So with the help of the capillaries, the blood in the blood, the digested food get mixed, okay? So the blood carries digested food from small intestine, okay? Next one, and that digested food which contained by the blood is get used to build a complex substances such as protein, and this is only called as what? Assimilation, okay? So the digested food is used to build the complex substances. Whatever the food get digested, that all the digested food is get utilized to build complex substances which is called as what? Such as protein. And this is that process, or the digested food is get utilized for what? So the digested food is get utilized to build complex substances, and which is the complex substances such as what? Proteins. And this is called as what? Assimilation. So why this protein is get utilized? What is the role of the protein in our body? So the protein helps to grow our body and also helps to wear and tear of the body, okay? To build our body and to worn out tissues are there, to make it clear, the protein is get used, okay? So in this way, the digested food is get utilized to produce the energy in our body in the presence of, we can say that, or in the presence of the oxygen, carbon dioxide and the water, the energy get released, and that energy is get utilized by the human being to perform the different activities, okay? So that also comes in under only what? Assimilation. So assimilation is nothing, in short, what we can say, the whatever the digested food is there, how that digested food is get utilized by the body, okay? So that digested food is get utilized by the body for to form a proteins, okay? And this protein is helps to build our body or to helps to recover our worn out tissues, okay? And the fats, the whatever the fats are there in the food, all that fats get stored under the skin as a reserve food materials, okay? So in this way, assimilation is happens, okay? So this is the fourth step of the digestion, and now we will move for the last step of the digestion, that is nothing but what? The process is called as what? Ingestion, okay? So now we will discuss for the next point from the topic, that is nothing but what? Large intestine, okay? So up till now we have discussed the different digestive organ, and now we have come to the last digestive organ, that is nothing but what? Large intestine, okay? So in the small intestine, the digestion process is get completed. The absorption also happens in the small intestine, but the whatever the food get we are eating, that all the food material doesn't get digested, okay? Among of the some amount of the food material is remain as a undigested, and that undigested food material is get passes from small intestine to the large intestine, okay? So in the large intestine, the undigested food comes, okay? And this large intestine is the wider and shorter than small intestine, okay? Here you can see that it is the wider than the small intestine, but it is the shorter than the small intestine. And the length of the large intestine is about 1.5 meter in the length, okay? So this large intestine has the two parts, okay? The large intestine has two parts. The upper part is called as what? Colon, okay? The upper part is called as colon, while the end portion or the lower part of the large intestine is called as rectum, okay? So the large intestine is having two parts. We can say that the upper part is called as colon and the lower part is called as rectum. So in the colon, what happens? When the undigested food comes into the large intestine, it has the more amount of the water. Okay, so all that water is get absorbed by the colon. Okay, so colon absorbs the water and the some salt. Okay, so in the upper part of the large intestine, the water and the some salts get absorbed, and that is the reason the undigested food becomes so much dry, or the feces of become so much dry. Okay, and all that feces is get transferred to the lower part of the large intestine, which is called as what? Rectum. Okay, so in the rectum, whatever the feces is stored in rectum. Okay, so the feces is get stored into the rectum. Next one, the feces is removed from the body through anus is called azation. Okay, so it is the last process in the digestion, that is what? Azation. What is mean by azation? The throwing out of the undigested food from the anus, that process is called as what? Azation. So the feces get removed with the help of the anus, and that process is called as what? Azation. And now the finally the digestion process get completed. Okay, so the digestion only includes that so many different processes. Okay, so it contains the basically five step. First one is what? Or the five processes, that is nothing but what? Ingestion. Ingestion means what? The food we are taking in, it is called as what? Ingestion. After that, the digestion process started. The digestion process get completed into the small intestine. After that, there is a absorption of the digested food, which is also happens in the small intestine. Next one is the assimilation of the food, or the assimilation of the digested food, which is happens in the all the parts of the body. And next one we called as what? The throwing out the undigested food from the body with the help of the anus, which is called as what? Azation. Okay, so all these processes includes in the process of digestion. Okay, so here we have complete our first system, that is nothing but what? Digestive system. We will meet in the next video with the next system. For today, thank you.